Formation of placenta. After the implantation of the embryo, the uterine endometrium is called the decidua. The portion of the decidua where the placenta is to be formed is called decidua basalis. The part of the decidua that separates the embryo from the uterine lumen is called decidua capsularis, while the part lining the rest of the uterine cavity is called decidua parietalis. The essential functional elements of the placenta are very small finger-like processes or villi. The chorionic villi are first formed all over the trophoblast. The villi related to the decidua capsularis are transitory and degenerate. This part of the chorion becomes smooth and is called chorion levi. In contrast, the villi that grow into the decidua basalis undergo considerable development along with the tissues of the decidua basalis. These villi form a disc-shaped mask which is called the placenta. The part of the chorion that helps to form the placenta is called chorion frondosum. The trophoblast is at first made of single layer of cells. As these cells multiply, two distinct layers are formed. The cells that are nearest to the decidua lose their cell boundaries. Thus, one continuous sheet of cytoplasm containing many nuclei is formed. Such a tissue is called syncytium. Hence, this layer of trophoblast is called syncytium trophoblast. Deep to the syncytium, the cells of the trophoblast retain their cell walls and form second layer called cytotrophoblast. The cytotrophoblast rests on the extraembryonic mesoderm. The syncytium trophoblast grows rapidly and becomes thick. Small cavities appear in this layer called lacunae. Gradually, the lacunae increase in size. At first, they are irregularly arranged, but gradually, they come to lie radially around the blastocyst. The lacunae are separated from one another by partitions of syncytium, which are called trabeculae. The lacunae gradually communicate with each other so that eventually one large space is formed. Each trabeculus is now surrounded all around by this lacunar space. The syncytial trophoblast grows into the endometrium. As the endometrium is eroded, some of its blood vessels are opened up and blood from them fills the lacunar space. Each trabeculus is initially made up entirely of syncytial trophoblast. Now the cells of the cytotrophoblast begin to multiply and grow into each trabeculus. The trabeculus thus comes to have a central core of cytotrophoblast covered by an outer layer of syncytium. It is surrounded by maternal blood filling the lacunar space. The trabeculus is now called a primary villus and lacunar space is now called the intervillus space. Extraembryonic mesoderm invades the center of each primary villus. The villus now has a core of mesoderm covered by cytotrophoblast and by syncytium. This structure is called a secondary villus. Soon, blood vessels can be seen in the mesoderm forming the core of each villus. With their appearance, the villus is fully formed and is called a tertiary villus. The blood vessels of the villus establish connections with the circulatory system of the embryo. Fetal blood now circulates through the villi, while maternal blood circulates through the intervillus space. The cytotrophoblast emerges through the syncytium of each villus. The cells now spread out to form a layer that completely cuts off the syncytium from the decidua. This layer of cells is called cytotrophoblastic shell.